Hello everyone. In today's video, I would like to show you how to set up the condensers in the condensers menu. So as a reference, this is our alarm button, our program or menu button, escape or back button, up, enter and down. So let's go into the menu. I would like you to use the manufacturer's password, which is 1234. And this will allow us to set all the relevant parameters. So 1234 and enter. Then let's go down to menu D, condensers, and enter. Then go into submenu B, regulation, and enter. So regulation by temperature and proportional band as per the wizard setup that we did in the previous video. So let's go down. You have some set point limits that you can set. If we go down, we have the actual condensing set point as 36 degrees. Like we did in the wizard. If you go down, fans work only when at least one compressor works. So I'm going to leave this as no. So what that means is the fans will only run while a compressor is running. If you say yes, the fans are able to run regardless if a compressor is on and off. So if we go down, you can enable a cutoff and some set points if you want. I'm going to leave it as no and go down. Temperature regulation, proportional, and my integral time is currently disabled, but you have the option to set up a little bit of an integral time. If we go down, temperature regulation differential is at 4 degrees, and I'm going to leave it at 4, and remember, as I said in the wizard, I like to always leave it a little bit bigger, and that will just assist in a smoother regulation of the condenser fans. Then we go down and then we're back at the beginning. So if we escape from this menu and we go down to alarms and enter. Now we have all the alarms pertaining to the condensers. So we have a high temperature alarm, which is absolute, and a threshold of 45. I'm going to leave it as is and go down. You have an condensing temperature differential of 5 degrees and an alarm delay of 60. Remember, this is all settable and customizable as per your running site. So if we go down, we have a low temperature alarm, absolute, and I'm going to leave it at 30 degrees. So let's go down. Then we have a condensing temperature alarm differential, again 5, and we have an alarm delay, which you can set. If we go down, common fans overload, yes, we do have one. We've got a delay and my reset for that alarm is automatic. Let's go down and then we're back at the beginning. So let's escape from this menu and go into configurations. Number of fans present is 1 as per the wizard that we did. So if we go down, we can see fan number 1 is enabled. And remember, you can disable it as well if you want. Let's go down. Refrigerant type is 507. Device rotation is FIFO. First in, first out. Remember, you have the option of last in, first out. Timings or custom. I'm going to leave it at first in, first out because it doesn't really matter. We only have the one fan. So let's go down. And then we're back at the beginning. So let's escape from this menu and go to advanced and enter. Modulating speed device is inverter 0 to 10 volts. That's correct. So let's go down. Modulate device config neutral zone. You can see it's disabled because we are not running a neutral zone. We are running proportional. We have a minimum output voltage and a maximum, so 0 to 10 volts. And then we have a minimum power reference 60 and 100. I'm going to leave as is and go down. We have some rising times and falling times. Remember, you can set this to either speed up your fans from start to stop, and the number of control fans is 1. If we go down, no, we don't have a split condenser, but you have the option to set one. If we go down, anti-noise is disabled. But remember, you can enable your anti-noise, you can restrict the fans, and you can restrict them either by digital input or by a scheduler. This will just help to lower the noise a certain time of the day or night. So if we go down, speed up is yes, and speed up time of 5 seconds. External temperature probe not present. So remember, if you have an external probe and we're running a floating condensing or something similar to that, we have to have an external probe and it will be present. So if we go down, enable condensing pressure backup probe, no, but you have the option to enable one. So if you have a secondary condensing probe, and then also you'll have some set points. If we go down, requesting fault of regulation probes fault. I've set this at 60, but remember you have to set this to your own site. And I think the best way to set this is if you let your site run for a week and you have a monitoring system like the boss, you can go back for that week and you can see what was your average percentage of your fans and then input this year. That will have the best regulation for the fans in case of a fault. If we go down, we're back at the beginning. So guys, this was the condensers menu setup, and then I will see you in the next one.